Magento and WooCommerce are two of the biggest names when it comes to e-commerce platforms. Today, let's look at the key differences between the two in terms of pricing, ease of use, performance, security, marketing, and support. After that, we will draw some conclusions regarding whether it is Magento or WooCommerce that suits you the most. Stay tuned. Hello and welcome back to our channel. I'm Marshall from Litextension, the world leading shopping cart migration provider. Okay, first things first, let me give you an overview of the two platforms before diving into the details. Now, both of them are open source platforms, meaning a little bit of coding knowledge will definitely make things easier for you. They both offer incredible functionality and flexibility while being absolutely free to download and install. So what makes the difference? Well, founded in 2007, Magento comes with a wide range of strong points. These include out-of-the-box functionalities, customizability, and seamless third-party integration. And most importantly, it targets medium to large businesses. On the other hand, WooCommerce developers have made the platform available to anyone, including those with little e-commerce experience. Launched in 2011, WooCommerce has thrived to become the platform with the most users in the world. It is a plugin that is added to WordPress websites, so in order to use WooCommerce, you will have to install WordPress first. So without further ado, let's get to the main differences to have you make a decision about which one suits you more. First, let's talk about pricing. There are two editions available, Magento Open Source and Magento Commerce. Okay, so Magento Open Source is a free platform with basic functionalities, so you will only have to pay for other things such as a hosting service starting from $10, paid extensions ranging from $15 to $500, a nice theme from $3 to $200, and finally a domain name from $10 to $500. Magento Commerce comes with a lot of amazing features, so the total price would definitely be higher. However, there is no fixed license fee for this edition. Instead, it is calculated monthly based on the annual gross sales revenue. Minimum price is $22,000 per year, and it gets higher if you generate more than $1 million a year. In this video, we're just going to talk about Magento Open Source. If you want more information about different versions of Magento, I'll put the link to our blog in the description. Now let's look at WooCommerce pricing. Although WooCommerce itself is free, you will still have to pay for similar fees such as a hosting service, a domain name, a theme, and some other plugins. WooCommerce themes usually range from $15 to $100, and plugins come at around $25. Similarly, the total price when using WooCommerce can't be projected exactly as it depends on the number of plugins that you want for your store. Note that you may have to spend more on plugins with WooCommerce than with Magento, as the platform offers fewer built-in features. However, when we look at both platforms, WooCommerce pricing is considerably more reasonable, as plugins and themes are generally cheaper. WooCommerce is a winner when it comes to pricing. This platform is more suitable for small to medium businesses with a limited budget. Now we'll talk about ease of use. WooCommerce targets small to medium businesses. Even though the setup process is a little bit complicated compared to hosted solutions such as Shopify or BigCommerce, it still has a touch of user-friendliness. WooCommerce comes with a setup wizard that walks you through initial setup like editing store details, selecting industries, and more. If you need help creating a store with WooCommerce, check out our tutorial video. I'll add the link to it in the description. This platform offers plenty of help with almost anything. It is highly customizable with your WordPress admin dashboard. You can easily personalize your website and theme options, which allows you to change the color of your design, add different functions to your shop, and insert pictures or videos. In contrast, Magento is tailored for web development professionals and medium to large online stores. The platform requires a certain level of coding knowledge to extensively utilize its potential. Therefore, there will normally be a need for professional developers when it comes to modifications. The Magento setup process is also also not so easy. Even though there are tutorials, they are mostly written for developers rather than typical users. We also made a video showing you how to create a Magento store. I'll put the link to it in the description. On top of that, you may have to look around for ways to set up extensions or customize themes after installation, as this process isn't easy either. So the verdict is WooCommerce is a winner here. The platform is considerably more user-friendly than its competitor. WooCommerce comes with an adequate number of built-in features. With this platform, you can run marketing campaigns such as discounts and coupon codes. You can also get access to reports of sales income, overall store performance, products, and customer reviews. WooCommerce supports a large number of payment gateways and lets you set free or flat rate shipping and configure tax settings. In contrast, Magento is considered a robust platform as it comes with a wide range of built-in e-commerce features that WooCommerce lacks. This platform provides the ability to control multiple stores with just one admin panel, and it supports multiple currencies and languages. The instant purchase functionality provides returning customers with a faster checkout experience using information that is saved in their account. Plus, Magento also has a built-in content management system which can be pretty flexible if properly utilized. The verdict? Magento is a winner here. WooCommerce built-in features are good but not enough. Instead, it heavily relies on plugins and coding. You will have to spend time looking around to find the suitable plugin to integrate a feature into your store, or you will have to hire developers to code the function that you want. On the other hand, Magento provides more useful out-of-the-box features. Magento and WooCommerce are both well known for a large number of add-ons that enhance the functionality and the appearance of the website. Running on top of WordPress, WooCommerce gives you access to more than 50,007 free WordPress plugins and themes. You can customize your store in terms of product type, store management, marketing, payment, shipping, and more. Plus, it is easy to integrate them into your WooCommerce store. Similarly, Magento comes with a vast variety of free and paid third-party extensions because Magento has a vibrant community of developers, agencies, and freelancers. At present, Magento Marketplace has nearly 6,000 extensions for various factors such as accounting and finance, marketing, sales, payment and security, content and customization, site optimization, reporting and analytics, and customer support. So the final verdict here is that it's a tie. Both offer an amazing number of extensions and plugins, which brings endless opportunities to utilize your online store. As a plugin based on WordPress, WooCommerce inherits all innovative blogging functions to support its e-commerce content marketing campaigns. In other words, there is no need to incorporate a blogging function to have your content available to visitors. Moreover, by utilizing shortcodes, you can insert any extra elements to your landing pages and blog sites easily. On the other hand, Magento is equipped with powerful SEO tools integrated into the core platform, which helps promote your search engine rankings. In addition, Magento creates a marketing menu for managing promotions, communication, user-generated SEO, and content. However, you should take into account that blog functionality is not available for Magento default, and you will need to use a custom blog extension for it. The final verdict? Here, I think Magento is the winner. Even though it doesn't have a built-in blogging feature like WooCommerce, you can add pretty much anything to your Magento store as it has a really powerful app store that makes up for the lack of some marketing features. WooCommerce remains rather secure itself as there are no marked security issues in WordPress. The core of this system has gone a long way to development, so it's quite safe. Problems may happen only when third-party apps get involved when setting up extensions. An article on WordPress-wide security has stated that 41% of hacked WordPress were hacked through a security vulnerability on their hosting platform. 29% were hacked via a security issue in the WordPress theme they were using. 22% were hacked via a security issue in the WordPress plugins they were using. 8% were hacked because they had a weak password. From the statistics, we can conclude that about 51% of WordPress sites will act via issues in the themes and plugins. Meanwhile, Magento itself has taken serious measures to make their sites secure. Users can go to Magento Security Center where they can get a lot of help from Magento developers. There is news to keep users updated about the latest alerts. The Best Practices section contains articles providing users with a lot of useful information and tips. There are also security patches released frequently to help fix vulnerabilities in the platform. To summarize, Magento and WooCommerce both meet the security standard, however, they can also be vulnerable externally. In this case, Magento seems to be more secure with its qualified security extensions. The final verdict? Magento is a winner here. Being open source platforms, both WooCommerce and Magento Open Source have huge user communities from around the world to support each other if they run into any problem. With Magento, the degree of customer support from Magento Open Source and Magento Commerce greatly differs. Magento Open Source support is rather partial. Users seek help in the Magento forums and communities solely. In contrast, Magento Commerce users will get the official full-fledged support, including email and live support. Similarly, WooCommerce does not offer direct support for users when troubles arise. In fact, merchants cannot solve the issues through live chat or phone. Instead, they can seek help from a large community whose members are willing to help. Besides, some resources such as FAQs, tutorials, and documentation are also available to guide users and help them deal with problems. Another way store owners can get help is by opening a support ticket on the WooCommerce website. Although it is stated that the WooCommerce support team will respond to your question within 24 hours, the actual time will depend on the complexity of your problems. So the final verdict is a tie. If you go for Magento Open Source, the support is kind of the same as WooCommerce. Magento Commerce, on the other hand, offers comparable support to that of WooCommerce support ticket system. Okay, we've come to the final part of the video. It's time to sum up and draw some conclusions. The two platforms are designed for different target customers, so it is really hard to tell which one is better than the other. Instead, it greatly depends on what you're looking for when building an e-commerce store. WooCommerce directs itself towards user-friendliness while maintaining low cost and flexibility. Meanwhile, Magento constantly aims for extended functionality and site performance. So if you're just getting started, WooCommerce is highly recommended. You can consider moving to Magento when you have a bigger budget to further develop your site. Alright, I hope this video gives you the idea of how the two platforms differ in order to make the right decision. Let me know in the comments what you think about WooCommerce and Magento and whether you've made up your mind. In case you need to migrate from WooCommerce to Magento and vice versa, don't hesitate to contact us. Litextension will help you transfer all the data from your current store to a new one while keeping your SEO ranking untouched. I'll put the link in the description, make sure to go check it out. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button for more interesting comparison videos and technical tutorials. See you next time!